Hello students, welcome to another video tutorial. So in the previous class we discussed about decimation in time FFT algorithm. Now in this lecture we will gonna discuss a numerical problem based on DIT FFT Radix 2 method. So this was the butterfly diagram which we derived for DIT FFT algorithm. Let us simplify this diagram further so that we can solve a numerical problem later. So in this DIT, this is the butterfly diagram. So in this diagram, these values W20, W21, W2^0, W4^1, W4^0, we can make these values uniform. So in the base of 8, we can make this on the base of n point, n is equal to 8 point DFT. So to make that, we will simplify these values further. So if we calculate W2^0 value, this is equal to e^-j 2π/2 into 0, this value is equal to 1. Similarly, we solve this W2^1 value, this will be equal to e^-j 2π/2 into 1 is equal to e^-j π, which is equal to -1. So we can replace this W2^0 value with 1, or you can simply write it as W8^0, which is also equal to 1. W2^1, we can put -1. So this bottom value will be -1, -1, -1, and this can be transferred here, which can be written as W8^0. Now similarly, W4^0, we can write it as W4^0 is equal to e^-j 2π/4 multiplied by 0. Can write it as 1, which is also equal to W8^0. So this can be bring over here, or we can write it as W8^0. And similarly, we can use this property of Tweedle factor WN/2 is equal to WN². So if we put n is equal to 8, so we can write W4^1 is equal to W8². So wherever there is a W4^1, we can put W8^2, and also W4^2 is equal to e^-j 2π/4 into 2, which you can write as -1. So wherever there is W4^1, we can put -1. So this will be equal to -1, this will be equal to -1, and W4^3 is also equal to W4^1 by periodicity property, and which is also equal to W8^2, which is equal to -1. So this is how we can further modify this butterfly diagram, and I have with me this modified diagram. So we put those values over here, and wherever there is a -1 value, which is W2^1, we put -1, -1, -1, -1, and wherever there were W4^1, which we can write as W8^2, which is also equal to -1. So we put over there -1, -1. So this is the modified butterfly diagram. So we will use this diagram to solve a numerical problem. Let us first write a numerical problem in order to solve this. So let us first take one example. So we have a sequence xn given as 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, comma 3, comma 2, comma 1. So this is capital N is equal to 8 point sequence, and we need to find x of k using DIT FFT algorithm. So this is the example we want to solve with the DIT FFT algorithm and by using a radix 2 method. So we will use this modified butterfly diagram for this. So to solve this numerical with this diagram, we require these factors, trivial factor values, w8 power 0 w8 power 2 w8 power 2 w8 power 0 w8 power 1 w8 power 2 w8 power 3. So overall we require three values of trivial factor. So let us first solve these values so that we can put those values in the diagram. So first we require w8 power 0. So this value, because capital N is equal to 8 here, we will calculate this value. So this is equal to nothing but minus j 2 pi by 8. So this is e raised to power minus into 0. So this will be e raised to power 0, which is equal to 1. So w8 power 0 is equal to 1. So now w8 power 1 is equal to e raised to power minus j 2 pi by 8 into 1. Is equal to e raised to power minus j pi by 4. So this value comes out to be, we can calculate this value by using Euler's formula. This will be equal to cos pi by 2 pi by 4, because cos minus pi by 4 is cos pi by 4, minus j sine pi by 4, because minus sine of minus pi by 4 is equal to minus j sine pi by 4. So this value comes out to be 0.707 minus j 0.707. Similarly, we can calculate value of w8 power 2, which is equal to e raised to power minus j 2 pi by 8 into 2. So this will be equal to e raised to power minus j pi by 2, which comes out to be minus j. Similarly, we can also determine value of w8 power 3, which can be given as e raised to power minus j 2 pi by 8 into 3. So this can be determined, and this will come out to be 0.707 minus and minus of j 0.707. So these are the values of these factors w8 power 0. Remember these values, we will put these values in our butterfly diagram. So w8 power 0 is equal to 1, w8 power 1 is equal to 0.707 minus j 0.707, w8 power 2 is equal to minus j, and w8 power 3 is equal to minus of 0.707 minus j 0.707. We will put these values in our diagram and we will further solve this question. So let us solve this question. So also remember one thing, that our xn is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. That means this value 1 is our x of 0. This value is equal to x of 0. This value is equal to x of 1. This value of x of 2, and so on. This value, last value, is of x of 7. So we will put these values in our diagram here. All the values we will put in the diagram, and then we will calculate further. So let us put these values. X of 0 is equal to 1, x of 4, this is x of 3, x of 4, x of 5, x of 6. So x of 4 value is equal to 4, x of 2 is equal to 3, x of 6 is equal to 2, x of 1 is equal to 2, x of 5 is 3, x of 3 is equal to 4, x of 3 is equal to 4, and x of 7 is equal to 1. So we now put the values of x naught to x 7. Now let us further solve this. Let me use a different pen so that we can write it more clearly. So this value is equal to 1, this is 4, this is 3, this is 2, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, and this is 1. So now let us put the values of Tweedle factors. So we have determined these values: w8 power 0 is equal to 1, w8 power is equal to 1, w8 power 0 is equal to 1, and this is also equal to 1. Now this value is also equal to 1. W8 square, now we look back, W8 square is equal to minus j, so this value we'll put here, this will be equal to minus of j. W8 power 0 is equal to 1, and W8 square is equal to minus of j. Now we come to the third stage, W8 power 0 is equal to 1, W8 power 1. Now remember, this W8 power 1 is equal to this value, 0.707 minus j 0.707, W8 square is equal to minus of j, and W8 power 3 is equal to minus 0.707 minus j 0.707. So now what we did, we have put all the values of the coefficients, Tweedle factor coefficients. Now we can start calculating the values, intermediate values first, and then the final DFT values. So let us now start determining the intermediate values. So this first intermediate value can be determined by adding these two values. First is x naught, and then x4 is multiplied by 1, then multiplied by minus 1, and it can be added to x naught. So x naught is equal to 1, x naught is equal to 1, x4 is equal to 4, it will be multiplied by minus 1. Sorry, what I did, I'm actually doing wrong. What I need to do is, this intermediate value can be determined by adding x naught value and x4 value multiplied by W8 power 0. So x naught and x4 are added, so what we will get 5. Similarly, this intermediate value at this point we can get by adding x naught value, which is equal to 1, and x4 value multiply by this 1, multiply by minus 1, and add it to this x naught value. So this will be 1, 4 minus 1, so this will be minus 4, so we will get minus 3. Similarly, we can determine these intermediate values. I'm just writing these values here so that we can solve it further. We'll get 5, we'll get minus 1 over here, we'll get 5, and this will be equal to 3. So let us solve for second intermediate value. Now this second intermediate value we can determine by adding this first intermediate value 5, and it will be multiplied by first W8 power 0, which is equal to 1, so 5 will be multiplied by 1, and this will be added to this 5, so we will get 10. Similarly, at this point this minus 3 will be added to this 1 multiplied by minus j, so 1 will be multiplied by minus j, it will be minus j, will be added to minus 3, so we will get minus 3 minus j. Similarly, at this point 5 will be added to 5 multiplied by minus 1, this will be this is equal to 1, so 5 will be multiplied by minus 1 and added to this 5. So what we will get? We will get a 0. So we'll keep on going and we can solve these values. So I'm just writing these values so that we can further solve at the third stage. So this will be equal to minus 1 minus 3j. At this point we'll calculate 0, and at this point it is minus 1 plus 3j. So these are the values at the end of second stage. Now let us solve for x, capital X naught, which is the first DFT point. So at the first DFT point can be determined by adding this value 10 with this value 10 multiplied by W8 power 0, which is equal to 1. So 10 will be multiplied by 1 and added to this intermediate value 10. So what we will get? We will get 20. So second DFT value x1 can be determined by adding this minus 3 minus j with this value minus 1 minus 3j, so that but first this minus 1 minus 3j will be multiplied with W8 power 1, which is equal to this value. So this value minus 1 minus 3j minus 1 minus 3j will be multiplied by this factor 0.707 minus j 0.707, and this will be added, this factor will be added with this value minus 3 minus j. So what we will get? We will get minus 5.828 minus j 2.414. Similarly, in this way we can determine all the DFT values. So let me put these values. So we'll not waste our time in calculating. Let me put these values. So this is equal to 0, this is equal to minus of 0.172 plus j 0.414. this will be equal to 0.